Hi, I'm Lauren from the City of Greater Dandenong Libraries, and I'm here today to do a really cool experiment with you called Rainbow Rain. Now, this is about how oil and water don't mix. But what really cool things can we do because they don't mix? We're going to find out. So, for this experiment, we're going to need a few things. We've got our oil. Now, I'm using vegetable oil, but you can use whatever oil you have. Get mum or dad to help you put a little bit in a cup like this. We also have some cold water in a nice clear jar. We're going to need this to make our rain, okay? We also have some food colorings. Now, the more food colorings you have, the more rainbow your rain will be. I have blue, green, and red. Now, I have spoons to help me put this into the oil, but if you have eyedroppers, it will be much easier. Just be careful because food dye can stain your clothes, so you might want to get mum or dad to help you out with that, okay? Now let's get started on our experiment. Just put the water aside there and we'll get our oil. Now, very carefully, one drop at a time, you want to add your food coloring. So we've got one, two, three, four, five. Doesn't that look cool? They just stay as little balls in the oil. Whereas in the water, something completely different might happen. Now let's add some other colors. We've got green. Very carefully, you don't want to add too much, just a couple drops of green. All right, there we go, some nice drops of green. And now, with a different spoon, we'll add some drops of red. All right, look at our rainbows. Now, you can see in the oil, we've got lots of little drops, but they're not really doing anything just yet. So, how do we turn this into our rainbow rain? You're going to need your glass of water and a nice clean spoon to stir your drops really, really fast, okay? So we're going to give them a nice, big, strong stir until we've got lots and lots of little tiny drops of food dye. What's going to happen when we add these to the water? Very carefully, you might want to get mum or dad's help. Pour your oil gently into your water. Can you guys see what's happening? All the oil has gone to the top and all the water has stayed in the bottom and they're not mixing at all. Now, if we wait just a little while, we're going to see something really cool. But now, it might take a minute, so don't worry if you have to wait. What's starting to happen here? Can you see? Our greens and our blues, they're all starting to come down like rain. Doesn't that look amazing? Wow. And the more colors you have, the more rainbow rain you're going to get. And see, all the food dye is flowing to the bottom of the jar. So even though we've got three liquids, they're staying in three different places. And that's because the food dye is actually much heavier than the oil and the water. So it falls to the bottom. And the oil is the lightest, so it stays at the top. You wouldn't think that there'd be a difference in weight, but that makes all the difference here. Well, liquid food colouring is made with water and doesn't mix with oil because the molecules that make up water and oil are arranged in a different chemical shape. Water molecules have a positive electric charge on one end and a negative charge on the other, which attracts water molecules together, just like magnets. On the other hand, oil molecules don't have a charge, so they are not attracted to water molecules and don't mix together. When the oil and food coloring is poured into the container of water, the mixture floats on top of the water and the food coloring droplets trickle down. This is because water is much denser than oil. The water molecules of the colored droplets are lightly packed together, making it heavier than oil, and sink to the bottom of the container like rain. Did you know the bubbles of a lava lamp work in a similar way to our rainbow rain, by using two liquids that don't mix together and have different densities? And when something dissolves in water, it makes the water denser. Seawater is denser than fresh water because it has salt dissolved into it. The water in the Dead Sea is so salty that it is much denser than the human body, and we can float on it very easily. So those are some really interesting facts about our science experiment today. I hope you'll join us for all our other really cool science experiments and other library programs. And we'll hope to see you next time.